In this lesson, we're going to cover infant rescue breathing for the healthcare provider. Our scene is safe, our gloves are on, our rescue mask is available with a one-way valve, and we're going to assess our infant. We tap on their feet, we rub their belly, we tap on their shoulder, baby, baby, are you right, are you okay? As soon as we establish that they're not responsive, we're going to go ahead and activate EMS, call 911, or activate a code. Now, we're going to go ahead and look for normal breathing as we check for a brachial pulse for no more than 10 seconds. As we check for this brachial pulse, if it's lower than 60 beats per minute, we're going to begin CPR. If it's above 60 beats per minute, we're going to go ahead and establish that the baby has a pulse but is not breathing. We're then going to cover the mouth and nose of the baby with the infant size rescue mask and deliver one rescue breath every 2 to 3 seconds for 2 minutes. We check as we give a breath for chest rise and fall, and we see it goes in and comes back out. Now we deliver only enough breath that we actually see the chest rise, and then we don't force more in. It's important to know that we're moderating how much air we put in just to elicit that chest rise and fall. 1,000, 2,000, 1,000, 2,000, 1,000, 2,000. Now, an important thing to note here is that we as adults don't usually breathe at one breath every 3 seconds unless we're exercising, and we could become hyperventilated. So what I like to do is take a deeper breath, hold it, and deliver about 3 or 5 or 6 different rescue breaths for my one breath, especially if I start to feel like I might be hyperventilating. So we're going to continue this for 2 minutes, recheck the brachial pulse. If there is still a brachial pulse but no breathing, we continue with rescue breathing. If there's no pulse or a slow pulse below 60, we're going to go into full CPR until the baby responds and begins breathing normally, help arrives, or an AED is available.